to his feet.
Hello, I'm Mayor Mark Carnevale, and it's my pleasure to discuss with you all the new development that has occurred over the past year in District 3, as well as the transformation of our downtown into an arts and entertainment district. After many years in the making, the crossings at Bob Hope Drive is rising out of the ground just north of I-10. In December, we celebrated the opening of the few first stores on this development. Currently opened is the new Starbucks and Taco Bell restaurants. Soon to open stores currently under construction are McDonald's, Arco AM/PM Fueling Center, and a 98-room Best Western Plus Hotel. It was just a year ago that the grading had begun, and now we are seeing this project come to completion. Another project that broke ground in 2018 and continues to rise is the Suniva Campus, a good manufacturing practice design facility located on Ramon Road. Working with the Dutch engineers with decades-long experience in clean food production using agricultural greenhouse technologies, Phase 1 is designed to be a 325,000 square foot medical grade cannabis cultivation facility that is anticipated to produce 177 pounds per year of dry cannabis at capacity and approximately 50% of initial production to be converted into oils and extracts. We anticipate this facility to be fully open and operating this summer. With new businesses springing up throughout the city, the need for new housing comes along with it. I am proud to state that two big housing developments are rising in District 3 in 2019. The first is the Verano Housing Development near the corner of Landell Boulevard and Verano Road. D.R. Horton, America's largest home builder, plans to build 329 entry-level homes. They have already made vast improvements to the community's clubhouse, pool area, fitness center, and meeting rooms. According to the National Association of Home Builders formula, 329 new single-family homes are expected to generate $94 million in local income, as well as $11.8 million in taxes and other revenue, and 1,296 local jobs. In the Rio del Sol neighborhood, just south of Gerald Ford Drive and East State Palm Drive, the Ryanton Group has announced its plans to build 210 single-family homes. With new jobs and new residents moving into Cathedral City, the transformation of our downtown into an arts and entertainment district could not be more important. Just west of the planned casino development is the long-standing Mary Pickford Theater that has undergone a complete renovation. In September 2018, they held a flip-the-switch celebration for their work on bringing solar power and energy battery storage technology to the theater, the first of its kind mass production power source for a theater in the state of California, and possibly the nation. The Mary Pickford Theater now generates nearly 100% of the power it uses through its solar panels and captures the excess energy from the panels to power the theater after sunset. Not only is the system saving the theater more than $100,000 per year on its electrical costs, but it also lowers its carbon footprint by not utilizing fossil fuels for its energy needs that can lead to the air pollution and climate change. You can now enjoy solar-powered popcorn. The third anchor for the Arts and Entertainment District broke ground in December and now continues to rise on the ground. The new $3.7 million downtown amphitheater is being built in part by CS Legacy Construction, who is charged with building all aspects of the park except for the stage portion of the park. The 2.5-acre downtown amphitheater park, adjacent to the parking garage at the corner of Avenida Lalo Guerrero and Cathedral Canyon Drive, will feature a permanent outdoor stage, restrooms, concession stand, children's play area, and walking path. With a seating capacity exceeding 2,900 people, this amphitheater park will be an ideal location for our city's festivals, art shows, food truck events, concerts, local theater productions, and much more. Completion of the downtown amphitheater park is expected the fall of this year. The fourth anchor to our downtown is the transformation of the old Desert Cinemas movie house into the new Coachella Valley Repertory Theater, known as CV Rep. It is the only playhouse in the valley to possess a small professional theater status with actors' equity. The theater has undergone a massive renovation with new lobby, state-of-the-art performing arts stage designed for plays and dance troupes. It will have its first performance, Chess, at the new theater on March 13, 2019, and a grand opening performance celebration on Friday, March 15th. Yes, Cathedral City is where art lives. Over the past year, the Public Arts Commission has provided this community with some major new art murals to our downtown. In October 2018, the council recognized mural artist Rick Rodriguez, world boxing champion Tim Bradley, and mixed martial arts and ultimate fighting championship competitor Kevin Luke Cub Swanson at a mural artist and celebrity signing ceremony. The artist and the celebrity celebrity signed the mural that is now completed on the wall outside of the 111 Fitness Club facing Highway 111. The mural of these two sport legends is part of local legacy mural program with its goal to incorporate art into the city's commercial zone. Just last month, the Mary Pickford Theater and the Cathedral City Public Arts Commission partnered together to have international street artist Kelsey Montague paint a large interactive public art display at the theater. The mural features a hot air balloon themed to Old Hollywood. It pays homage to the Cathedral City Hot Air Balloon Festival, as well as the film industry. Together, working hand in hand, we will rise to the new heights far beyond our wildest dreams.